Tectonic plates are the rigid outermost layer of the Earth. They can spread away from one another, causing volcanism, and forming new rock that becomes part of the plates. When this happens under the ocean, it forms a volcanic ridge called a mid-ocean ridge. As the plate travels under the ocean, the rocks in the upper part of the plate become hydrated with ocean water. Areas where one plate is sinking beneath another plate are called subduction zones. The sinking plate, also called the subducting plate, bends down and continues descending into the hot mantle. This is what is happening beneath the northwestern United States, forming the Cascadia subduction zone. Where the two plates meet on the seafloor is called the trench, which forms the deepest areas in the world. The mantle, while solid, is still able to move at speeds similar to the tectonic plates. When the subducting plate sinks, it ends up dragging the overlying mantle downward, and this sets off the movement of the mantle in this wedge-shaped region, called the mantle wedge. As the subducting plate sinks into the hot mantle, it heats up, and the rocks in the upper part of the plate release the water that they had absorbed under the ocean. Some of the water moves into the mantle wedge, and this addition of water lowers the melting temperature of the mantle rocks, triggering magma formation. The magma travels toward the surface, ponding and forming magma chambers, and eventually erupts to form volcanoes. These volcanoes are one of the most dangerous types of volcanoes due to their violent, explosive eruptions. Subduction zones host another hazard, earthquakes. When the overlying plate gets stuck to the sinking plate for some time and then suddenly gets released, it generates large earthquakes called megathrust earthquakes, and they can generate large tsunamis that can devastate nearby coastal regions. We can also have earthquakes in the subducting plate, indicated by the pink dots. These occur due to faulting within the subducting plate as it sinks. These earthquakes can also be damaging because they can occur beneath areas with high populations. Finally, earthquakes can also occur in the overlying plate due to rupturing of faults in the shallow overlying crust. These typically occur even closer to areas with higher populations and can also be very damaging. Temperature, stress, and water distributions in subduction zones control earthquakes, arc volcanism, and many other important processes. And in this research lab, we try to better understand these physical and chemical conditions.